Parallel to all the craziness happening in part one, we were off converting massive amounts of these things into temporary pieces of art. Although we don't think about it much, electronic waste actually includes much more than laptops and computers. It includes all the peripherals that come with them, most obviously, keyboards. This was the basic idea. Build a massive structure using broken, discarded keyboards with a floating ring of Dell monitors, which are actually built from recycled plastics. I took to social media, inviting volunteers to come and help us out. We needed volunteers to help with sorting, painting, screwing, cutting, and lifting. They streamed in from all over the country, excited to be part of something so unique. Together, we got creative, experimenting with different keyboard patterns, figuring out what looked good and what didn't. So many people came to help us out that we ended up having to request more keyboards from the facility because we had grown our structure way bigger than we had anticipated. Meanwhile, David, our hero builder, came up yet again with a couple new solutions to my crazy ideas. The first was making a small black stool on a thin metal rod that would make it look like our model was levitating. And then he built this massive octagonal frame that could swivel and rotate while supporting 8 of the brand new Dell monitors made from recycled plastics. With our structures slowly coming to life, all that remained was to add the human component, which I believe is the most important part of the recycling process. After all, if nobody brings in their old electronics, there's not gonna be anything to recycle. Makeup artist Tamsin Ray teamed up with body painter Allison Blue to transform a beautiful model, Clara Coutier, into a futuristic being over the course of 8 long hours. With lighting set to green and laptops levitating with the help of some dental floss, we were ready to go. Until I realized one big problem. See, although they were super cool and we had spent so much time building them, they just ended up stealing away the attention from the entire structure as well as the model. And so what that meant was that we were gonna have to take them down. All right guys, that's it for part 2. Make sure you go on the website and sign up for updates so you don't miss part 3 where we reveal the third and final structure. It's actually my favorite. All right guys, see you around next time.